Somebody please define the word simulation for me. Briefly, so I move on. Simulation, what is simulation? Yeah. Along, but it is, but then in English, please. Along is correct. A mock-up, okay. It's a representation of the reality, representation of something in the reality. And in this context, we're representing the nature evolution. What is evolution? Can someone help me define what evolution means?
To adapt to
change. Adapting.
Living.
I hear the word change. I hear the word adapt.
Adapt for living.
Adapt for living. So if this is this room is really cold, I put on my jacket. Am I evolving?
No.
How so? But I'm adapting.
I'm adapting the bodies.
Okay. Okay. So bringing back your high school biology class memory, pretty much. But evolution is actually a process whereby in each successive generation, the animals, the species, the offspring, is adapting, getting closer and closer and more suited to the environment. Okay. For example, the turtle is building hard shell, and over the generation, they build even harder and harder shell to protect themselves and survive. Okay, that's an example. And so how do we simulate this evolution as a process? That's the difficult part. So in this exercise, in the next 2 hours and a half-ish that Brian has planned for you, is that you will engage in this complex multi-component, meaning that there's a lot of components to the detail. So when I say multi-component, let's break down the component first. So evolution is something that takes place in the nature. If it's something that takes place in the nature, what's inside your nature? What can you find in the nature? Can I ask someone to brainstorm a couple things that take place or a couple things that exist in nature?
Water.
Water definitely exists in the nature.
Trees.
Okay, tell me more.
Rock.
Tell me more.
Animals.
One person, please.
Animals.
Animals. Tell me more.
Air.
Tell me more.
Heat.
Okay.
Energy.
Okay. All of these terms are very broad. So if I were to categorize some of these components that you see in the environment, I would say that there's a biotic component. Have you heard of the term? Have you heard of abiotic component? Biotic. What is abiotic? What is abiotic? Which one's living? Definitely. So living components in the environment. So that would be animals, trees, but beyond that, there's many more. Tell me more specific because animals is such a broad term. Give me some specific example.
Carnivores.
What do they do? I don't know if everyone knows the term. They eat meat, definitely. And as opposed to carnivore?
Herbivore.
Okay, as opposed to herbivore?
Omnivore.
What do they eat?
Both.
Okay. And can you give me some example of carnivore?
Tiger.
Thank you. Herbivore?
Cow.
That's good. Omnivore.
Humans.
Guys. Pigs, definitely. Pigs are considered as omnivore. They consume both plants and the meat. And so these would be considered as the biotic component. And when it comes to biotic component, they will interact. Okay, let me park the word biotic there. Give me some abiotic component and we'll move on.
Rocks.
Rocks. tree, huh?
No.
Water.
A light.
The only thing. The heat, the energy, the air, they are abiotic components, but they do exist. And the biotic components interact with the abiotic components. So in order to simulate such an event where biotic components interact with the abiotic component, you actually have to have both components involved. Now I'm gonna complicate this game even more to add more into this multi-components exercise. So with these games, different animals, give me some examples of animals.
Dog.
Tell me more. Cat. Now, come on, go. You guys are going domestic. That's really close. I'm gonna give you fish next one. Give me something in the wild. Ant, insects, tiger.
Caribou.
Okay, keep going.
Bear.
Dragon. Commando dragon. Because insects. Oh, that works. Monkey. Okay. So there's actually a lot of animals in the wild, and each would have their specific traits. I'm tossing up the word traits. What are traits? Give me some example of traits. Yes, their characteristics. Tell me about their characteristics. Give me some example of characteristics.
Long ears.
Give me some animal that with long ears. Rabbit, definitely. And the purpose is to listen to the sound, of course. Tell me more about the traits. Character. Camouflage. Give me some example of the animal that camouflage.
Chameleon,
of course, but that's not the only animal. Tiger. Okay. Tell me more. What's the unique characteristics of tiger? Have stripes. Okay. That works. Moving in packs. Tiger moving packs. No, they tigers depends on which species. Lions do moving packs. But then the tiger probably are solid to carry. So very solid to carry. Tell me more.
Hornbill.
What do they look like? The beak is unique. There's a horn that are on the top of it. You can find them in Thailand. We have quite a bit of hornbills in the wild. Yeah. And what's unique about the hornbill? They can actually fly.
Yeah.
And what's the advantage of flying? What is the advantage of flying? You can move to places. And when you can move to places, what's the advantage of that? You can find more food, definitely. You can interact in a greater area. Think comparing between ants, where they just walk around in this specific area, whereas bird flies to further distance. Then there's different advantage there, right? Okay, so these traits are also a component in the environment. Also a component is the abiotic component, and then the biotic component is also the component in the environment. In this game, I'm adding more complexity to it. So when we talk about animals, is it just one animal present? No, there's many species. So I'm gonna have to add the word species into it. Can you see the word? Okay. What is a species?
Okay. Like group of animals would have the same characteristics.
Definitely. Groups of animals, group of individuals that have the same characteristics and can interbreed, produce viable offspring. That's like biological science definition. So this different species would have different characteristics. Different species would not interbreed because they behave differently, right? So human as a Homo sapiens species, tiger as a pantera, and I'm gonna run out of my Latin words to describe that because I don't really know the specific Latin word. But each species would have different traits, different characteristics.